Hello.
Welcome to my channel. I am so glad that you decided to stop by and see what I am up to today. And if you don't know who I am, I like to call myself the Humble Bumble, and I am pollinating the world with the good news of the gospel. Any way that I can, honestly, any way, it doesn't matter. I just want to get it out there. And I know that some people out there seem to think that gospel is an ugly word.
Bruh.
It doesn't have to be. In fact, whether you are saved, unsaved, confused, or just looking for something to believe in, I know that we have a conversation, something that we can talk about. So today, I'm actually not wanting to have a typical video because next Thursday is Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is a time for family. Thanksgiving is the time that we gather, we all get together. And since my videos don't come out until Friday, I thought that I would talk about Thanksgiving a little this week and that we would sing a few songs to make up for the fact that I haven't put songs out in the last couple of weeks, guys. Life happens. That's all I'm gonna say. And so I really just want to go ahead, just like a kid who gets to the side of the pool and they're afraid to get in because they don't know how cold it is. So they take and they dip their foot in just to see how cold the water is. I'm not gonna do that. I just wanna go and I wanna run and I wanna jump in because I miss praising my Savior. I miss it. So today that's what we're gonna do. Thanksgiving is a very special time. It's when families get together, and honestly, there's always that one go-to house. So it doesn't matter wherever you are in the United States, wherever you are in the world, you're gonna probably get a ticket to fly home if you have to so that you can spend time with your family for Thanksgiving and Christmas, at least one of the two, depending on how far away that you are. But when I was a little girl, I used to have a very big family. I had a pa and a grandma, and I had a mom and a dad. I had aunt and uncles. I had cousins, oh plenty. I mean, so many. And I had them growing up, and we always had the big Thanksgiving together, you know. But unfortunately, when my mamma passed away, she was the first to go. The family stayed together, but it was only long enough until my papa passed away, and like families do, they just seem to lose touch. So I don't really have Thanksgiving with my family, that like my aunt and uncles and everything, because my grandparents have passed, my parents have passed, my husband's mother has passed. I just don't have a big family. I'm thankful for my sister and for my brother. We only get together though once a year instead of twice because they work so much. So I am telling you this because I want to tell you guys a story and I want to tell you what I'm thankful for. And if you would, please leave me a comment. Tell me what you're thankful for. I would love to hear it. So I love TJ Maxx. I don't know what woman wouldn't love TJ Maxx, but I love TJ Maxx mostly for its home goods, and I also love it for the skincare products and everything because they have the really high-end stuff at the most ridiculously low prices. And I know that you have a TJ Maxx where you live, so you should really check that out. Anyhow, I was walking around and I had not really found much of anything, but I had a couple of things in my buggy and I decided that I was just done. The line at TJ Maxx is usually pretty long. So while you're standing in line, they know this, and they end up putting like these shelves up so that they have all these different little doodads and things for sale. So you're bound to pick up something. It's just a random assortment of everything throughout the store that they can put on these shelves. You know, just in case you might have missed it. They always get you. And while I was standing there and I was looking, I guess I had a family on my mind. I wanted a family. I have a bad habit when I go out of looking at other people and watching other people. This is a bit touchy to me. Small children with their parents or husbands and wives that are together with, oh, I don't know, a group of people and they look like maybe that's their mother and father-in-law or something. It's just a group of family. I like to imagine what it must be like in their family. Not that I'm envious. The Lord says that we don't need to be jealous of other people. We don't need to covet. But I'm not coveting. I don't want to be anybody else but who I am. That's fine. God designed me to be who I am, and I'm happy with me. It's just I really desire a family. And so while I'm standing in line, there is this wooden sign, and it says family. Now, I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm going to take some pictures so that I can put them up here for you. But my brother went for Christmas one year, and he bought me a few things. And it has this font on it. And if you don't know what font is, it's just the text. It's how it's drawn. This is the font. Okay, and I'm not sure what the name of this font is, but it's very typical for today. And you see it all over everything. Everything. And I'm one of those people that I like to be different. But for whatever reason, even though I hate this font, I feel compelled to buy it because I wanted to buy something that said family. I have been asking God heavily for a while for a family. And I thought, I'm not going to make a vision board, but I'm going to buy this. I think it was like $5.99. And I was like, I'm going to buy this. And God, whenever you decide to send me a family, I'm going to know that I bought this the day that I asked, and I'm going to remember that. Well, 2.5 weeks went by. My son decided to come back home. And for this, I am so very thankful. So when you ask God for something, when it is not in vain, and I know that asking him for a family is not in vain, that he's going to give it to me. So again, if you haven't subscribed and you're not a part of my family, I would sure love it if you would be. Because I know there are so many conversations, so many things that we can talk about. And you know what I promise? I promise never ever to shove the gospel down anybody's throat. Because we're all human beings. And God still died for you. And I don't want to shut anybody down. I don't want to turn anybody away. And I have found that the world can be more accepting than the church is. I longed for a family when I was in the church. I have to honestly say that I never felt like I fit in. I'm not the only one. But you know, I'm going to tell you a funny story. So when I was living in the world, this was when I lived in Knoxville, Tennessee, I used to be a bartender, and I am so sorry that I was a bartender because honestly, to tell you the truth, it did weigh heavy on me at the time. Sure, it's just work, and that's what you're doing, but we can choose to do anything. Why, as Christians, would we want to choose to help someone get intoxicated and possibly do something that they don't need to be doing? Because I'm telling you, when I was in Knoxville, Tennessee, I saw a bartender lose his license because a man came in without his girlfriend that always comes in with him. And when the bartender asked him where his girlfriend was, he said, she's probably dead. He thought he was joking, but he really wasn't. And the police came to the Applebee's that I worked at, man. And he ended up losing his license because they thought that he had came in there and drank prior to him killing his girlfriend. He beat her to death. They were together for over a decade. We don't know who we live with, let alone go to church with. I'm just saying, stop trusting, start testing. But something that I did learn is that Thanksgiving is actually the biggest holiday for bars. The biggest. And this is because the people who go to those big family get-togethers, they can't stand each other. It's literally like it is in the sitcoms on TV. They get into arguments and fights, and then they end up just splitting and going to a bar and getting drunk if they don't have some alcohol hidden in their car. And even though they're comatose, basically, from all the food that they ate, now they want to get trashed. And I also know that this is the big time of year for accidents and stuff on the road due to drunk driving and everything. So guys, please be careful, be smart. If you really must do those things, please have a designated driver. Be smart about it. As a bartender, I saw this stuff way too much. But unfortunately, Thanksgiving is the biggest drinking holiday. But I still have to say that if I had a family, you know, to go to and eat with and everything, I would be so tickled. I would be so excited to know that I was invited, not out of obligation, but I want to be invited. I want to have a Thanksgiving. I would love to sit down at a table, and I would love to have a family to sit with. That would be so amazing. I can remember what it was like growing up. So if you have a family today, if you have a Thanksgiving that you're going to, and you have that family that's calling you up and asking you what casserole dish or whatever it is that you're going to bring this year, put love into it. These are memories that you are going to make that you will remember for the rest of your life. Spend that extra little bit of money this year and get some pecans instead of marshmallows for your sweet potato casserole. Don't use hot dogs and the macaroni and cheese. Get some Smokies. I don't know. Just put that extra little love in it, because you never know when this will be your last. So before I sing, I just want to let each and every one of you know that I love you. But please, hug your neighbor today. Love your neighbor and love your family, because they're not promised tomorrow. Make those memories while you can. So I've got my first song ready. I really don't know how many I'm going to sing, but I definitely wanted to start out with one that I remember. And as a choir leader, of course, we had to do this on every Thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. While the world looks upon me as I struggle along, they say I'm not worthy, but they are so wrong. In my heart, I'm rejoicing. How I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. There's a roof that's up above me. I've a good place to sleep. I've got food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. I know I'm not wealthy, and my shoes, they're not new. I don't have much money, but Lord, I love you. And to me, that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. There's a roof that's up above me. I've a good place to sleep. I've got food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. I love my family. I love my YouTube family, my son, my husband. I love my family, my sister, my brother. Thank you. So this next song, I don't know why, but I'm just feeling led to sing it. And if God wants me to sing it, I'm going to sing it. I know it's a really good old one. A lot of people may not know it. It's called Life's Railway to Heaven. Life is like a mountain railway with an engineer that's brave. We must make the run successful from the cradle to the grave. Watch the curves, the fields, the tunnels. Never falter, never quail. Keep your hand upon that throttle and your eyes upon that rail. Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blessed shore, where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forevermore. You will roll up grains of trials. You will cross that bridge of strife. See that Christ is your conductor on this lightning train of life. Always mindful of instruction, do your duty, never fail. Keep your hand upon that throttle and your eyes upon that rail. Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore, where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forevermore. I love that one. Okay, and this next one I love, because I did this one a lot as a choir leader. This was one of those that was sure to set the room on fire. Somebody was going to scream and shout, so sing with me if you know it. Glory to His name.
Down at the cross where my Savior died, down where for cleansing from sin I cried, there to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. It was there to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to His name. I am so wondrously saved from sin. Jesus so sweetly abides within. There at the cross where He took me in. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to His name.
So this next song is going to be my last. I'm going to end with something a little slower. Something that's a little more soothing. Something that might help someone, you know. Maybe it's a song you haven't heard in a while. One that's going to bring back some good memories. I don't know, but what I do know is that this is good anointed music. I hope you enjoy it. It is called I Am Thine, O Lord, or some people know it as Draw Me Nearer.
I am Thine, O Lord, I have heard Thy voice, and it told Thy love to me. For I long to be in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to thee. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by thy power of grace divine. Let my soul look up with a steadfast hope, and my will be lost in thine. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. There are depths of love that I cannot know till I cross that narrow sea. There are heights of joy that I may not reach till I rest in peace with thee. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side.
Well, I really hope that somebody out there enjoyed today's episode, that somebody grows for God. And I just want to let you know that if you haven't already, I would sure love it if you would hit that subscribe button, be a part of what I am doing and what God is doing for my ministry. I just want to tell each and every one of you that I really do love you with my whole heart. I wouldn't be doing this because it's not easy. But I'm going to keep up the good fight as long as there's just one, because heaven rejoices over just one. So have a safe and wonderful time with your family this Thanksgiving, and do it with a song in your heart. And until next time, I hope somebody out there has a beautiful and blessed day.
There's shoes on my table and shoes on my feet. Please tell me why. It's all in my mind.